Hello guys, and welcome to this tutorial where we are going to create a typewriter effect. So let's start by creating a main scene. Go to scene, save scene, create a new folder and call this scenes. Click on save. Now let's create the typewriter effect scene. We click on scene, new scene, click on 2D scene and call this typewriter. We're going to add 2 new timers. So right click the typewriter node. Click on Add Shell Node, search for Timer, click on Create, and repeat the process. Rename the first timer to Type Timer, and the second one to Delay Timer. Next, right-click the Typewriter Node, add a Shell Node, and find the Audio Stream Player, and click Create. And rename this guy to Audio Stream Typewriter. Next, we're going to right-click the typewriter node and click on Attach Script. Change the C# script here and click on the path here. Let's create a new folder and call this Effects. In here, we're going to create a new folder and call this typewriter. We're going to open this file right here. I'm going to click on Create. And this will open up Visual Studio Code for us. I'm going to delete some junk in here. So in here, we're going to add a couple of variables. We're going to start up here with the type timer, which is how long to delay between every character. Next, we are going to keep track of the text position that we are in right now. Then we're going to add the parent label node, so we can access that guy. And we're going to have a private variable here to keep track of which text to type. And we're going to have an initialize flag here as well to keep track of if this typewriter has been initialized. And we're going to have a private boolean here. We can flag when it's okay to start typing. Then we're going to have an audio stream typewriter sample that we're going to play whenever we are running the typewriter. All right, so inside of the ready method, we're going to get the type timer and the audio stream typewriter sound here. So we can access those really quickly. Next, we are going to implement a new method here called prepare to type. Here we check if the parent node is a label. And if it is, then we're going to get the parent label node here. Then we're going to get the text from the parent label node. And we're going to empty the parent label node text. Then we're going to make the parent label node visible so you can see what's being typed. And finally, we're going to flag that the typewriter has been initialized here. Next, we're going to go back to the editor quick. We're going to connect some signals. So click on the type timer and click on node and double click the timeout method here. And we're going to connect this to the typewriter script that we are working on right now. And I'm going to change this to a bit more C# standard here. Like so. Mark that, right click, copy, and click on connect. And this will open up the Visual Studio Code Editor again. In here, I'm just going to say private, void, and paste that guy in. And inside of here, we're going to do the following. First, we check if the text position has not reached the end of the text. And if it hasn't, we're going to copy the current character that's in the text to type here on the text position and add that to the parent label node text here. Then we're going to start the type timer here to go to the next character in the string. And we're going to increase the text position here. So the next time we come in here, we will grab the next character in the string. Otherwise, if the string has reached its end, we're going to set the text position to -1, flag that this is no longer initialized, and we're going to stop the audio stream here from playing the typewriter sound. All right. Next, we're going to go back to the editor quick. Click on the delay timer, double click the timeout here, and we're going to connect it to the typewriter script as well. I'm going to change this to a bit more C# standard here. Like so, I'm going to mark this. Right click, copy, and click connect. I'm going to write a new method here, private void, and paste that guy in. And inside of this guy, we're going to add the following lines. We're going to reset the text position to 0, and we're going to start the type timer, and we're going to start playing the typewriter sound. And next, we're going to make everything tick here, and this is in the public method that we're going to add here, which is going to be the start method. So inside of here, we run the prepare to type method that we created up here to initialize everything. Then, if everything was initialized properly, we are going to start the delay timer. And once the delay timer stops, we're going to reset the text position to 0, and then we're going to start the type timer. And once the type timer times out, we're going to run the code in here that we went through earlier. All right. We can also delete the stuff in here. So we have now created a typewriter where we can set how long it's going to delay before the text starts to type, and also how long it's going to take between each character to be typed. We can define that in here. Go to the inspector. We're going to change this to 0.1. And we're also going to change this to a one-shot timer. This means that it's not going to automatically restart by itself. We want to be able to control this by ourselves. The same with the delay timer. Right now, it's 1 second before it starts to type, and that's okay. And we're also going to set this to a one-shot timer because we don't want this to restart by itself. Now click on scene. Save scene here. We're going to go up a level. We're going to the effects folder, the typewriter folder, and we're going to save this scene as typewriter.tsen. So click on save. Next, go to the main scene, right-click the main scene, click Add on Child node, and we can add a sprite in here. And for this, I prepared a background. I click on Open in File Manager. And I'm going to copy in a file in here. Bold paper bg.png. You can use whatever file you want. I'm going to use this guy here. I click on assets. I can now import this guy in here as a texture. And I'll quickly going to change this to full HD. So product settings. I scroll down here to window. I'm going to go 1920 by 1080. I click on close. And the background here is going to be transformed. It's going to be centered here. You can do it really quickly like this. Type in 1920 divided by 2. And also the height, 1080 divided by 2. And you will have centered your background like so. Next, let's add a label here. Right click the main node. Click on Add Child node. Find a label. Like so. Hello from the label. Right now, this is a really small text. So what we want to do is we want to find a font for this. So we can use that instead. I'm going to bring up a web page here. So what I've done is I've downloaded the Chomsky font and I have converted this to a TTF file, which I will include in the project on GitHub. So you can download it there. So I just want to show you that this is a free font that you can use. I'm going to close this guy down. I click on assets, right click and click a new folder and type in fonts in here. I right click and open that in the file manager. I'm going to copy in font in here. We now have it right here. Click on the label. And go down here to theme overrides. Click on fonts. Click on empty. Click on new dynamic font. Scroll down and click on font. And click on the font data. Click on load. Go to assets, fonts, and choose the Chomsky font and click on open. I'm going to change the color to black. And the setting here to like something like 80. Now it's really nice and big. We can drag this guy to the edges of the paper, like so. And we can align this to the center, and the center, like so. So we now have a nice label there. What we do now is right-click the label, instance the child scene, attach the typewriter.tsen file. And what we do now is that we hide the label. Now right-click the main node, click on Attach Script, and save this as it is right now. Click on Create. And in the render method, what we got to do is to get the node here. It's going to be the typewriter node. It's going to be located right here, this guy. And go dot start, like so. Now go on File and Save All. save, minimize, and click on play. Click on select current. And it's typing out here. And finally, let's add a sound to this guy as well here. So we can go down here into the effects folder, typewriter folder, right click there and click on new folder. Call this SFX. And I'm going to open this in the file manager. Now you can go to this website here, soundj.com, and get the typewriter sound here. And in terms of use, you can use this for films, videos, games, presentations, animations, and so forth. So for your YouTube videos and also for your games. But there are some things you can't do, and you can read them more in detail here. But for all purposes, this is all okay. So what I've done is that I downloaded this sound, and I cut it off a bit to be a bit shorter. And I copy this guy in here. Typewriter.wave. I'm going to load this guy into the sound effect here. Like so. Sounds like this. And also when you import it, click on this guy, click on import, and click on loop, and click on re-import. So that the sound will be looping when it reaches the end. All right. So let's save this guy and run again. And there you go. This is how you create a typewriter effect. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and see you in the next video. Bye for now.